Welcome to the third part of the 8085 and Z80 programming. There's another way to load and store the accumulator of a register pair. Okay. Accumulator is 12. Set a BC register to address 100. Setting the DE register to address 110. Store accumulator with extended register or with register pair B. Let me change A and store accumulator with register pair D, E. Okay, and load it again. Load AX from B, load AX from E. DE, of course. So A is 12, BC and DE. Store accumulator, it will store the value of the accumulator to the address defined in B, BC. Address 100. 12 is changed and store the accumulator to the address defined in DE, it's 110. So let me change this, 33, 99. The next command is load accumulator from B, 33, and from D, 99. The load X with register pair HL or store AX with register pair HL does not exist because it's already covered by the command move A, M or move M, A. Okay, let's do the same in Z80. Let's load. Load BC, DE, and here it's load at memory address defined in BC. So let's do the same. Okay. Zero. That's fine too. Yeah, we have an error here. I want to load it, not save it. So it's A, comma, and here's the same. A, comma. Let's do it again. memory. Five, zero, step. Okay, the next command is saving a 16-bit value. Let's specify the HL register. Store HL double at address, let's say 100, and load HL double at address 100. So the SHLD will store HL to the address 100, and it will first save the low byte and then the high byte. So low byte, high byte. Let me change this. 01 or 01 02. Okay, that's covered. Let's do the same in Z80. LD HL, and here is load at address 100, the value, or the value in the register HL, and here HL loaded from the address 100, load. Okay. Saved 10, 10, 11, 11, and 10. Low byte, high byte. Okay. The difference with the Z80 is that you can also specify different registers here, like the BC, DE, DE, HL, IX, IY, and even the stack pointer. So let's give a last example with IY. 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 I know it's not easy to retain and understand all these commands and restrictions. The only way to remember them is to practice a lot. Assembler programming can be very tedious, especially on older 8-bit computer systems. A lot of older computers in the 70s and 80s shared the same CPU, but the hardware was different, like video, sound capabilities. Even the memory could be at various locations. So, see you in the next part. Bye bye.